Talos Incident Response Team with a story from the field. I want to talk a little bit about whether or not to involve lawyers during an incident, or when you should involve them and when you shouldn't involve them, and how to make that decision as a security leadership team. You know, the reason I bring this up is that this actually comes up fairly often. You know, one of the things that we do during compromises and during breaches, we often interact with lawyers. We often recommend that lawyers be involved during with our investigations, and we during some of our proactive services that we deliver, such as writing incident response plans, doing tabletop exercises, and whatnot, we often recommend that a lawyer be involved in that process. And I want to explain a little bit about that reasoning, why it's important, particularly for some of the technical folks, because oftentimes technical folks see lawyers as the adversary or as the other adversary in the room. What does a lawyer do for your organization? What does your general counsel's job, right? If in layman's terms, the general counsel's job is to help minimize the risk, the legal risk, to the company or organization you work for. It's actually very similar to the responsibility of a security practitioner, right? Doing cybersecurity, whether it's incident response or whether it's security engineering or security architecture, our job is to minimize and manage the risk to the company, the business risk, and allow them to continue to function normally, right? Lawyers are the same thing, but their perspective is from a legal perspective. What does that have to do with compromises, cybersecurity compromise and breaches, right? So first of all, let's level set on some language too, right? So a cybersecurity compromise, in my term, is a incident in which the security or the someone gains unauthorized access to your information systems, right? So an individual, an adversary acting in a malicious manner, gains access to your systems without authorization. A breach is the next step up above that, where they don't only gain access, they also steal or make copies of critical information. So you have a data breach in addition to the compromise. And so then the question is, where should lawyers come in on this? For some cybersecurity practitioners, their opinion is that lawyers should not be involved until there's been a confirmed breach related to that incident. And I'm gonna make a comment on that one here in a second, right? But that when you have a compromise, that lawyers shouldn't even be told that this is occurring, right? And hopefully not too many of you feel that way. But if you do, I'm gonna try to change your mind here. Right. Because lawyers, general counsel's responsibility is to manage risk for the entire organization. Anytime that there is a potential impact to that risk, the general counsel should be at least informed that something is going on. Otherwise, they can't do their jobs, right? If we're withholding information from them, or withholding information to them until we think it's relevant for them to know, then we're potentially negatively impacting the companies that we work for. So the recommendation is that anytime there is a confirmed compromise, that the general counsel for your organization is informed that that's the case. Because a compromise can very quickly lead to an actual data breach, or you could have an assumed data breach even when there's not necessarily an abundance of evidence to justify that conclusion that there's a data breach. So the recommendation is fairly simple, that if you have a confirmed compromise to an incident, that general counsel should be informed that there's been an incident, and that if there is a data breach, that you've confirmed there's a data breach, that general counsel should take responsibility over the entirety of the incident and establish attorney-client privilege on that incident, right? Ultimately, though, all of this is your general counsel's decision to make, right? If your general counsel is informed of a compromise and they feel that they're justified in establishing attorney-client privilege and taking over responsibility of that incident, that's their responsibility and their call to make, and it's in your best interest to allow them to make it. Well, look over the workflow for your incident response plan and see where the lawyers come in. And, you know, if you never bring up lawyers in your incident response plan, now's a great opportunity to reach out across the aisle to your general counsel, get them involved in the incident response plan a little more deeply, work with them specifically to figure out when and how they should be notified of an incident. It's pretty straightforward, right? They're stakeholders in the cybersecurity process as well, and we should involve them in it. They're there to help us. We're there to help them. We're all here to help our companies do better, manage their risk better, and continue to operate normally.